Hello students, today we discuss about the anomalous secondary growth in Aristolochia. In previous video, we discuss about the two genera Achyranthes and first one is the Bignoni. Then today we talk about the Aristolochia. First of all, in previous video, I talked about the anomalous secondary growth. So, what is anomalous secondary growth? So, it is any change in the secondary tissue, that is vascular cambium or cord cambium. There is the in the addition of secondary tissue, in that some changes are happens. Due to these changes, the anomalous secondary growth are observed in the various plants. So today we talk about the plant Aristolochia. This is the picture of the plant Aristolochia. It is also a twinner plant. यहाँ पे हमें दिख रहा है twinner, that means the climbing plants. It shows normal cambium with the abnormal activity types of anomalous secondary growth. इस plants में हमें कुछ anomalous secondary growth हमें दिखाई देती है. Then it is adaptive types. It is also a adaptive type, that means that is the evolved. They are adaptive, that means some adaptive characters. It is सम इवॉल्व कैरेक्टर्स और वो इवोल्यूशनरी कुछ चेंजेस रहते हैं. दैट मीन्स जो क्लाइंबिंग के लिए अभी जो कुछ प्लांट्स स्ट्रेट रहते हैं तो कुछ प्लांट्स हैंगिंग और क्लाइंबिंग रहते हैं. और ट्विनर प्लांट्स है, ट्विनर है मतलब इसे दूसरे जो भी सपोर्ट रहेगा उसको उसके आधार पे वो उसकी ग्रोथ होती है. तो सपोर्ट के लिए उस प्लांट में कुछ मॉडिफिकेशंस होते हैं, दैट इज द एनामलस सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ. एडाप्टिव मीन सम मॉडिफिकेशंस आर ऑब्जर्व इन दिस सेकेंडरी टिश्यूज. देन इन द दिस इज द प्राइमरी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ Aristolochia स्टेम. This is the figure or transverse section of the stem. In the transverse section, outer layer is the epidermis, below epidermis there is the cortex region is present. Then below cortex region there is the endodermis ring is present, and below endodermis pericycle is present. Then at the center there is the four vascular bundles are observed. In that the xylem are present at the inner side and phloem is present on the inner side and xylem is present on the outer side. And there is the presence of intravascular cambium. Intravascular cambium means which is present in between the vascular bundle, in between the xylem and phloem, that is the intravascular cambium. At the center there is the pith region is present. This is the primary structure of Aristolochia. Then this is the figure of early stage of secondary growth which is observed in the Aristolochia. In early stage there is the intervascular cambium strips are formed. Intervascular, that means in between the two vascular bundles, the intervascular cambium strip is developed. Then these intervascular and intravascular, intra means in between the vascular bundle, so intravascular and intravascular cambium, these are united and form a cambium ring. This is the cambium ring. Or vascular cambium ring. Clear that? यहाँ पे इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम एंड इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम बोथ आर यूनाइटेड एंड दे फॉर्म ए रिंग दैट इज द वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम रिंग और कैम्बियम रिंग. देन आफ्टर सम टाइम्स और आफ्टर सम ग्रोथ व्हाट्स हैपन दिस इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम. This is intervascular or intervascular cambium adds more xylem towards inner side and less phloem towards the outer side. फिर क्या होता है जो intervascular cambium क्या करता है कि जो inner side की तरफ xylem ज़्यादा add होता है और phloem कम add होता है. Then after certain times इंट्राफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम एड्स पैरेन्काइमा ऑन इनर साइड दस इट डेवलप्स फ्लोटेड झाइलम. फिर क्या होता है जो इंट्राफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम है वो क्या करता है कि पैरेन्काइमा एड करता है पैरेन्काइमा. दैट्स वाई दिस कैम्बियम इज डेवलप्स फ्लूटेड झाइलम. तो यहाँ पे तो एक अलग से यहाँ पे फ्लूटेड मीन्स एक कटिंग पोर्शन और एक अलग सा पैच वहाँ पे झाइलम का एक पैच वहाँ पे तैयार हो जाता है. देन व्हाट्स हैपन देन द इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम स्ट्रिप्स एड पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स ऑन आइदर साइड इट रिजल्ट्स इंटू प्रोमिनेंट मेडुलरी. जो टू वेस्कुलर बंडल्स के बीच का जो एरिया है दैट इज द इंटरफेसिकुलर. तो इन दैट एरिया इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम स्ट्रिप्स ऑल्सो एडेड द पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स एंड ड्यू टू एडिंग दिस पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स इट रिजल्ट्स इंटू द यहाँ पे हमें प्रोमिनेंट मेडुलरी रेज यहाँ पे तैयार हो जाते हैं. देन आफ्टर सर्टन टाइम्स ऑफ इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम फॉर्म्स द स्मॉल वेस्कुलर बंडल. देन दिस इज द स्मॉल वेस्कुलर बंडल्स. आफ्टर सर्टन टाइम जो इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम है दिस कैम्बियम फॉर्म्स द स्मॉल वेस्कुलर बंडल by addition of secondary xylem inner side and phloem on the outer side. Then it develops fluted parenchyma. फिर इसके अंदर फिर जो fluted parenchyma के patches यहाँ पे तैयार होंगे. Simultaneously cork cambium जो outer region है यहाँ का this is the vascular cambium और जो साइड वाला पार्ट है दिस इज द कॉर्क कैम्बियम. देन यहाँ पे जो डेवलपमेंट होती है साइड बाई साइड यहाँ पे क्या होता है कि जो कॉर्क कैम्बियम डेवलप्स इन कॉर्टेक्स एंड फॉर्म्स पेरिडम. जो कॉर्टेक्स यहाँ पे जो कॉर्टेक्स रीजन है वहाँ पे पेरिडम लेयर तैयार होता है. देन the formation of fluted xylem and fluted parenchyma helpful to aristolochia for climbing. तो ये सब adaptive changes किस लिए हो रहे हैं क्योंकि जो plant है plant के climbing के लिए जो plant है twinner plant है उसे climb करने के लिए कुछ modification plants के अंदर होने चाहिए. So these are two main, that is the fluted xylem and fluted parenchyma, that means medullary rays are helpful to aristolochia to develop or helpful in the climbing to the jo other plants. Jo cluttered xylem है and जो medullary arrays है, that means cluttered parenchyma है, क्या करता है कि climbing के लिए plants को मदद करता है. So this is about the Aristolochia. Look this figure. In this figure, after the anomalous secondary growth, there is the at the center pith is present. Then this is the four vascular bundles. In that interfascicular cambium and in between interfascicular cambium is present. So this interfascicular cambium are united and forms this ring. Then what's happened? This intrafascicular cambium kya karta hai? There is the addition of xylem on inner side and less phloem on outer side. Then kya hota hai? There is the formation of the parenchyma. So this is the parenchyma. Cluttered parenchyma is there. Then what's happened? Then this interfascicular cambium develops the small vascular bundle. Up in that interfascicular cambium also develops a this small vascular bundle. In this also there is the cluttered parenchyma are present, and in that there is the cluttered parenchyma and medullary rays are formed, and simultaneously in cork cambium there is the periderm layer is developed. So this is the structure of transverse section of Aristolochia after the anomalous secondary growth. See this. This is the secondary xylem, parenchyma cell. This is the secondary phloem. This is the cluttered parenchyma. Then cluttered xylem. This is the secondary cortex. An outer layer is the cork cambium, and this is the then this is the figure of Aristolochia stem. First one is the 1 year old plant and this is the 2 year old plant. So how the secondary growth is developed, you see in this figure. Look this figure. This is the vascular bundles. In this figure two large size vascular bundles are here and two and four smaller size vascular bundles are there. The four vascular bundles are united to each other or connected to each other by their interfascicular cambium. This is the interfascicular cambium. These are the vascular bundles. This is the 8 vascular bundles. Then is the white is the cortex region. Then epidermis and cholenchyma on this. Then after the 2 years plant, this is the vascular bundles at the center. Pith region is present. In that, this is the primary xylem, secondary xylem, secondary phloem and primary phloem, and that intrafascicular cambium is there. Then in between two vascular bundle, that is the interfascicular cambium is there. Then there is the on the outer layer in between the two vascular bundle some medullary rays are developed. In that space there is the medullary rays are present, and the outer layer, that is the Halogen, phylloderm, cork cell, lenticels are also present on this outer layer. So these are some adaptive characters are observed in the stem of Aristolochia, which will help to plant for the climbing. So lastly, we conclude that first, this is about the plant, that is twinner plants, and some adaptive characters are observed in this plant. This is the primary structure of the stem. Then some anomalous secondary growth are observed in this plant, that is interfascicular cambium. Then inter and interfascicular cambiums forms the cambium ring. Due to this intrafascicular cambium, more xylem add on inner side and less phloem on outer side. Then after sometimes these cambium or intrafascicular cambium adds some parenchyma on inner side and it develops the flooded xylem. Then these interfascicular cambium streets also add parenchyma and they form prominent medullary rays. Then this interfascicular cambium also forms some vascular bundles. In that vascular bundle, similar way it develops also the flooded parenchyma cells. Simultaneously, in the cork cambium, this cork cambium develops the cortex and forms the periderm. So these are the some adaptive characters which are observed in this Aristolochia, which are helpful for this climbing. Lastly, हमने figures देखे जो transverse section of Aristolochia after the secondary growth. Also, there is some changes or some how to grow these plants is seen in this figure, that is first year plants and second year plants. So in this way, this is the anomalous growth found in this cambium or vascular cambium. That is two main characters are observed, that is the flooded xylem and flooded parenchyma, that means medullary rays are observed in this Aristolochia. So I hope all of you understand about this Aristolochia or anomalous secondary growth in Aristolochia. So now we stop here.